Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marievo, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. So in today's video, I'm going to teach you how you can create your own thumbnails for YouTube absolutely for free using Canva. I'm going to show you how to use Canva, both the free version and some extra features with the premium version, and you can sign up using my link in the description below and also get a free trial for Canva Premium. Now, learning how to create your own thumbnails for YouTube is not only useful if you have your own YouTube channel, but this is also an excellent skill to have if you want to sell this skill on websites like Fiverr or Upwork, or you can even reach out to different YouTube channels and offer to create them thumbnails for a set fee for each thumbnail. A lot of people upload videos to YouTube and they don't use a custom thumbnail. And this is a mistake because people are more likely to click on a video if they like the way the thumbnail looks. So I'm going to show you exactly how to use Canva to create your own YouTube thumbnails. I'm going to show you how to customize all the different YouTube thumbnail templates that are already available for you in Canva. But I'm also going to show you how to create a thumbnail for YouTube completely from scratch. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos like this one, where I teach you how to become a work-from-home freelancer and to make money online. So let's get started. So once you click on the link in the description below, you can click here and go to start your free pro trial. Now you can create any of these YouTube thumbnails using the free version as well. And Canva has so many different templates for all sorts of different things that you might want to create. But what we're going to do is under Search Canva, type in YouTube, and then you want to click here on YouTube thumbnail. Now you can see here the dimensions are 1280 by 720 pixels. So we're going to click on that. And here we can either choose to create a blank YouTube thumbnail, which I'm going to show you how to do afterwards, or we can use any of these templates. And you can look on the side and they've got different templates by style. So you can click feminine, for example. Or you could also choose by theme. So let's say you're doing a beauty blog and you want a beauty template. Let's say a travel, workout, fitness, makeup, health, technology. And you can go ahead and use any of these different templates. So let's say you're doing a product review video. You can go ahead and click on any of the templates that you want to use. So I'm going to click on that. And this will open up the YouTube thumbnail that we can now make any sort of edits that we want. So here at the top, if you want to edit the text, we can just click, and let's say you're doing, you know, an iPhone review, and you can just type in the text that you want. Now, if you want to change this text, you can just go, you can highlight the text and then go here and choose whatever text that you want. You could type in the text or just scroll down and choose whichever one you like the most. And then you can change the size by clicking here. And if you want to move the text, you can just click and move it around. And they've got these grids, so it helps you snap it so it's in the center. You can also change the text color by clicking here and going ahead and changing the color. Now we've got these different elements as well. So let's say I want to change this and change the color. So let's say you want to erase one of these images. You can just click on the image and click delete on your keyboard. You can also click on the image and then if you want to rotate it, go like this, expand it. Now let's say we want to change the background. You can go ahead, click on background, and you can use any of these backgrounds here, or you could choose a solid background or a gradient background. There are all sorts of different backgrounds that you can choose. Now let's say you want to add another element. You can click here on elements. You can add any of these shapes. Let's say I want to add this shape right here. And then you can go ahead and click and drag it to the size that you want. Let's say I want to do this. And if you want to bring this to the back, we can just right click and go send to back, and that way it's behind. Let's say I also want to add a rectangle. And then to change the color of any of your elements, we can just go up here and click on this box and then change it to whatever color you want. You could also click on this icon here and then manually choose whatever color you want, or click on the eyedropper icon and then choose a color from your image so it matches, let's say this. And then you can just click and drag. And that's what I love about Canva. It's just so easy. And again, to change the layer, you can just click on any object that you want to change the layer and then just right click and go send to front. So let's say you want to add your own picture. You can go ahead and click on uploads and then you can click on upload media. Now let's say you don't have a lot of pictures to use yourself and you want to use one from the internet. You can go to a website like unsplash.com and here you can use any of these images in your YouTube thumbnails without having to attribute the author. Okay, so let's say I want to use this picture here. I'm going to click on download free and then click on upload media and just locate your picture. If we just double click on it, that will bring it right here for us to use. So then you can just click and move it how you'd like it. Now, let's say we want to remove the background here. What we're going to do is click on edit image. And then here we're going to click on background remover. Now this you can only do if you have the premium version. So if you don't have the premium version, you would either just use the background or choose a different image. So we're going to click on background remover. And you can see that that has just removed the background for us. So we're going to choose apply. And now we can go like this and add this to our image. So again, you can just play around with this, moving all the elements until you're happy with it. And we can also add effects. So we can click on this guy here and go edit image. And then you could also add any filters that you want. Or you could add a drop shadow and then just click apply. And so when you're happy with your YouTube thumbnail, you can go ahead and click on download. And then here under file type, we're just going to download it as a PNG file. Now again, this is okay. You can do this even if you just have the free version. It's just with this little crown icon are things that you can only do if you have the pro version. So then we're just going to click on download. Okay, and just like that, we have a really catchy thumbnail that we can use. Okay, so now I want to show you how you can make a YouTube thumbnail completely from scratch. Again, we typed in YouTube thumbnail. We're going to click create a blank YouTube thumbnail. So here we have the proper dimensions, and the first thing we want to do is add a background. I'm going to click on background and choose the color. So I'm actually going to choose red, and I'm going to create the thumbnail that I'm going to use in this video. Now the next thing I want to do is add my image. So again, I'm going to go to uploads, click on upload media, and locate my image. Okay, so now I've uploaded this image of myself. I'm going to click it to add it to my document here. I'm going to just make some adjustments to the size, and now what I want to do is remove the background. So again, I'm going to click edit image. I'm going to click on background remover. And you can see it's done a pretty good job of removing my background. Okay, and then just click on apply. So what you can do is use any of these filters. You can also adjust the intensity of the filter as well. You can click see all and you've got all these different filters that we can use. So we can choose glow. And what that will do, will create like a drop shadow sort of glow around the image, and you can choose the color and then the size of the glow and the transparency and the blur and choose apply. So to adjust the size, we can just click and drag. Now I'm going to choose elements and I'm going to choose this square here. I'm going to just click and drag it so it's the length that I want. I'm actually going to adjust this a little bit like that. And I want the image of me to go in front of it. So right click, bring to front. And now I want to add some text. So I'm going to click here, text. And you can choose any of these text templates if you like. Or you can just click add a heading and choose whichever one you want. I'm going to click on this one, add a heading. Now I'm going to highlight this text and change the color to white. And I want to change the font type. Click and drag this up here and then rotate it like this. And now choose add a heading again. And then again, you can choose a different text if you want. And you can also add effects to your text by clicking on effects and then choosing to add a shadow and then choose the color and make it a black shadow. And you can choose to, you know, change any of these settings if you want as well. Add a blur and then adjust the transparency as well. You could also add any of these other effects as well. And you can add as many images as you want. If you add a PNG file that's already transparent, when you add it, you won't have to remove any of the background because it's already a transparent file. I'm going to click on edit image. And again, I want to add a shadow to this. So again, you can see all the different effects that you can add. And then you can add any other sort of elements that you want. You can just type in, let's say, for example, arrow and use any of these. And then if you want to rotate it, you can click on flip. And then you can just rotate like this. There we go. Okay, and when you're finished, you can just click on download and then download once again. Okay, and just like that, we've created a really nice, catchy YouTube thumbnail for our YouTube videos. Again, you can have fun experimenting with this. It really depends how much effort you want to put into these. You could add more elements if you want. And this is a great skill for you to have because not only can you use this skill to create your own YouTube thumbnails, but you can also sell this skill on websites like Fiverr or Upwork. So I recommend just to start practicing and really get good at this skill, and eventually you can go on to sell your services. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you want more tutorials on how to use Canva for advanced users, let me know in the comment section of this video. And if you are interested in any other tutorials on how to get started as a YouTuber and making money on YouTube. Thank you guys once again for watching, and I will see you in my next tutorial.